When I was a kid in college, my friends and I used to go out and drink in bars. But the bars in Kansas used to close at 2 o'clock in the morning. And so at 2 o'clock in the morning, because we were young, we still had a lot of energy. And one of the things we used to do is drive out to the lake and go swimming at 2 o'clock in the morning. It seems crazy to me now, but we were really quite happy when we used to do that. And one of the things I used to like to do is while I was swimming, I would lay on my back and I would look up. Because the lake was a ways from town and everything was very dark there. And when you looked up, you could not only see the stars, but you could see the whole cloud that was the Milky Way. Those images used to fill me with a kind of joy and enthusiasm and wonder. It made me think about the nature of God, my place in the universe. It really did fill me with a kind of inspiration. You know, Plato used to say that, or used to write at least, that wonder is the beginning of knowledge. And looking up at those stars really did inspire me. Inspire is an interesting word. For the Greeks, it meant to breathe in. And that's how I felt when I beheld this kind of wondrous image. One of the things I noticed is that my friends, and maybe they learned it in scouts or at summer camp or whatever, they all seem to know the names of the different constellations and the names of some of the most important stars. They seem to be able to tell which stars were planets and which ones weren't, and they just knew things. And I was studying a lot of mythology, and I thought that I should know this stuff too. So I made the stupidest, dumbest mistake of my college career. I took a class in astronomy. I thought that we would be spending our time looking at the stars and looking through telescopes, which we did one time, but I thought that's what astronomy was going to be about. That's not what astronomy is about. Astronomy is a math class. It's a pretty high advanced math class, and it was really difficult for me. We spent a lot of time looking at negative pictures of stars, where the stars are black and everything else is white. And mostly what we were doing was measuring things and calculating things and doing very complicated math problems. I hated it. It was awful. It was so tedious. It was so minuscule. There was no joy. There was no enthusiasm. There was no wonder. I mean, it was 35 years ago, but I recall it was hard to get out of bed in the morning to go to this thing. And we talked very much about chemicals and the chemical compositions of the sun and atomic reactions. And I suppose I did learn a lot, but I did not enjoy it at all. It was sort of a mood killer. Now, I want you to remember my story, and I really want you to think about it, and I want you to apply what I've said to you to Walt Whitman's story. It's called The Learned Astronomer. That's the poem that you're going to go read now.